The Daily Recap, December 5th, 2012. AT&T Video explains your cell phone bill. Yes, AT&T is launching a service that will actually explain your bill individually via video. So this is like, I don't know, some next level detailed billing. It'll actually have a customized video just for you to show you an itemized viewing of your cell phone bill. Pretty awesome. The upcoming iTunes 11 update will restore duplicate song detection. As you may know, CoverFlow is no more with the new iTunes, but something else was left out, the feature that finds duplicate entries. See, that's missing. So iTunes is going to be updated to restore this feature, but still, no CoverFlow. Purported backplate of the rumored iPhone 5S. Well, yeah, this is supposedly the iPhone 5S, obviously. There's really not much you can tell from that, besides some different screw locations. Is Samsung now king of cool? Well, at least when it comes to advertising, it appears so. Samsung's Galaxy S3 ad, the whole next big thing is here advertisement, bested not only Apple's, but plenty of other competition for the most popular tech ad of 2012. It beat the iPhone 5 promo. Completely revamped Twitterific 5 for the iPhone and iPad goes live. I'm not sure yet if it's out right now in the US store, but it is available in international store. It brings with it brand new spanking iPad interface, offline support, multiple count support, customizable themes, threaded DMs, lots and lots of different things here with this new Twitterific. So if you're tired of Tweetbot, which, you know, let's face it, it's the only option for Twitter users this up to this point, at least, then you might want to try out Twitterific 5. It looks pretty cool. And lastly, Casio announces a new iPhone-friendly watch. Yes, the Casio smartwatch uses low-powered Bluetooth 4.0 to connect to your iPhone 4S or 5 and performs a handful of useful functions. Now, that being said, the notification features of the smartwatch are pretty limited. It only works with emails and calls. But it also will allow you to send a signal to your iPhone to play an audible alarm, and it can sync to the clock app and a few other things here or there. Check out the video on iDownload blog if you want more information, and check iDownload blog for all the posts from today. Lots of news today, lots of cool things to talk about. Make sure you share your thoughts in the comment section below. This is Jeff with iDownload blog.